Good morning, children. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Myself, Sanmesh, and today we are going to discuss Class 8 Physics Assignment, which was given to you on 9th of July. This assignment is based on the chapter Chemical Effects of Electric Current. So let us start. So our first question is, who discovered chemical effects of electric current? Now, the first evidence of chemical effects of electric current was given by an physicist, Luigi Galvani. He was an Italian physicist. So in 1971, when he passed on electric current through a solution, accidentally he discovered that there are certain chemical changes produced in the solutions. And his discoveries or his inventions was proved again and again by Volta, again a professor from Italy. With the help of various experiments, he proved that there can be a chemical effects of electric current. Whenever an electric current passes through a chemical solution, there can be chemical reactions happening in those solutions. I hope the point is clear, children. Let us proceed to our next question. How does an electric current cause chemical change? Now, whenever there is an electric current flowing through a chemical solution, there can be various chemical reactions, and that can be observed and that can be confirmed with the presence of bubbles in the solution. For example, whenever the current is passing through a chemical solution, bubbles are created or bubbles are generated in the solution itself. And sometimes there may be change in the color of the solutions also. Also, the metal electrodes which are dipped inside the solution, we can see the metal deposition on those electrodes. So using all these evidences, we can confirm that there is a chemical effect of an electric current. So passage of an electric current through a conducting solution causes chemical reactions. It causes chemical reactions. As a result, the bubbles of gas may be formed on the electrodes. Also, deposits of metals may be seen on the electrodes. There can be deposits which can be seen on the electrodes, and changes of colors of the solution may occur. So there can be also change in a color of a solution. So these all are the chemical effects of the electric current. I hope the point is clear, children. Let us proceed to our next question. What is a poor conductor of electricity? Now this is a very simple question. The objects which do not allow heat or electricity to pass through them are known as poor conductors of electricity. Generally, non-metals are the poor conductors, or which we call them as insulators. Okay. Whereas metals are very good conductors of electricity. So poor conductors are the materials that does not conduct electricity, that does not conduct heat, electricity, or both. Okay. Now, non-metals are typically insulators, which are poor conductors, non-metals. Whereas metals like copper are very good conductors. Metals like copper are very good conductors. That's why we use them in making utensils and electrical wires. I hope the point is clear, children. Let us proceed to our next question. What metals make good conductors of electricity? Now, metals like copper, silver, aluminium, gold, steel, brass are common good conductors of electricity. I have listed few metals here. These are the good conductors of electricity. Now, amongst these, silver and gold, they are very effective conductors. Silver and gold, they are very effective conductors. So the question arises, then why don't we use silver and gold in our household circuit? Then why we use copper? The answer to that question is, silver and gold are very expensive. Okay, they are rare metals and they are very expensive. Whereas copper is cheaper as compared to silver and gold. It is a lot cheaper. That's why we can use copper, because it will also give us good results. Okay, whereas silver and gold will give us best results, but still copper can give us good results in cheaper price. That's why we use copper in our household circuits as compared to silver and gold. But remember one thing, silver and gold are very effective conductors as compared to other all metals. I hope the point is clear, children. Let us proceed to our next question. What does a conductor of electricity mean? Now, a substance or a body which conducts, which allows heat or electricity to pass through them are known as conductor. The example I have given is copper is a good conductor of electricity. I hope the point is clear, children. Let us proceed to our last question. Which metal is the best conductor of electricity? Just now I have discussed, silver is the best conductor of electricity because it contains a large number of free electrons. That's why the silver is considered as a best conductor. But still, we use copper because of the low cost than the silver and gold. I hope the point is clear, children. All the solutions are clear. Thank you. Thank you so much.